How are your kids doing? Yeah, I mean, it's important for us to talk about, right? As adults, we often talk about how we're feeling, how we're coping, how we're not coping, but how are your kids? Now, I know many of you have checked in on your kids and you know exactly how they're doing, but this is a good reminder for us to check in on our kids and to make sure they're doing okay. Because honestly, just like stress, anxiety, uncertainty affects adults, it also affects children. And that's what we're seeing during this day and age of coronavirus. Symptoms that we can see in children, of course, vary depending on the child, but they also vary depending on the age. So in very, very young children, sometimes signs of stress, anxiety, uncertainty can manifest as regression of milestones. For example, a child that was previously potty trained may now be bedwetting. Or that child that slept through the night before now may want to sleep in mom and dad's room or maybe getting up in the middle of the night. That child may also be a little bit more clingy or fussy than usual. But now let's go on to school-aged children. Some signs and symptoms that we may see in school-aged children are things like abdominal pain, belly pains, or headaches. Maybe lack of concentration during daily school time, which is happening at home for most of us, right? And just sort of a general change in mood and behavior. Older children may be more withdrawn. They may be showing signs of frustration or anger. They may be showing visible signs of being anxious. And of course, with them, their mood may be different as well. They may also show signs of sadness. I think what's most important during this time is that we check in with kids and see how they're doing and also try to help the best that we can. So some tips for helping is, first of all, of course, I always say ask and then listen. So asking your children how they're doing, what they think, what they know, what they don't know, what they have questions about. This goes a long way for letting your child know that you are open and interested in how they feel and what's going on inside them. And then listening is so important. Listening without judgment, without interruption, and listening openly. The next thing is answering questions that they ask. Of course, honestly, but certainly at the level at which your child functions and can understand. That sort of age-appropriate response from the parent is going to be very important when talking about coronavirus and what's happening in the world. Reassure them. You guys know as adults, we need reassurance. Well, your kids need reassurance as well. And that's reassurance that we're going to get through this, which is the truth. Remind them of hard times that you might have endured as a family before and how you've gotten through them and how you will also get through this. Probably will not only help your child, but it probably will help you too. Keeping a routine is super important for kids. Honestly, routines are golden. So keep that routine going. And when things get a little crazy and a little crazed and everybody's frustrated and at their wits' end, you go outside. Yes, literally go outside because fresh air can really do a lot for the mind and the body. Of course, you want a social distance, but don't forget taking breaks and getting some fresh air for your kids, and for you as well. Another thing, parents, I think it's really important is to cut everybody some slack. Guys, this is not the same as pre-COVID, okay? This is a whole new normal, and cutting everybody some slack is gonna help not only you, but it's also going to help them. And finally, modeling good behavior, modeling good coping skills is gonna be so important. This is a really important time for us as adults to check in to see how we are coping. How are we doing? Are we managing our stress properly? Are we managing our mood and our feelings properly and appropriately? Because us doing that will help our kids immeasurably. They will get examples, real life examples, on how to cope in times of stress. Guys, I hope this is helpful. Make sure that you're checking in on your kids and checking in on yourself. Please share this video with anyone you think might benefit from it. And if you're interested in sending stars, of course, I answer your questions first. Guys, I'm Dr. Jen Caudill. Please stay safe, and I'll see you soon.